Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel, pivot table data crunching for slicer selections. Well, hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. We're working through the pivot table data crunching book. Here in chapter 4, we're talking about slicers. Just want to talk a little bit about how these slicers work, being able to select values. It drove me crazy at first. I didn't get it. So I'm going to go to Options, Insert Slicer. We'll choose, let's do Region and Market. That'll be good. Click OK. All right, so you see that we have two sets of slicers here. And on the left side, I'm going to choose North and Northeast. So I click on North, drag down to Northeast, and that selects both of those. Now, interesting colors here. The items that are in full color are available in the North and Northeast. So Baltimore, Buffalo, Dakotas, Great Lakes, and New England are the markets that are in the selected regions. If I would select different regions, then we have different markets that are available. Okay, and then the things that are sort of, well, not really grayed out, but just kind of faded out, are the items that are not even available based on the other selections. Now, I'm going to go through and choose a couple of items. I'm going to choose Seattle and Baltimore. All right, so now you have a couple of interesting color combinations here. The items that are white and grayed out means that they're unselected and there's nothing based on the other slicer things over here. The items that are full color means that they are selected and we do have some hits based on the other slicers. The faded out color means it is selected, but again, no hits because of the grayed out. The items that are white that are not grayed out, those are items that would be available had we selected them, but are not currently selected. Now, so it's really easy to go through and choose things that are contiguous. You just click and drag and release, all right? So that is really easy. But that's never what I want to do because, face it, there are things you want to filter to. How often are they alphabetically next to each other? Just never happens. So what you can do is you can choose one item, California, and then hold down the Control key while you go choose the other items that you want and then let go of the Control key. All right, so a little tough there to select those. I frankly think it should be a multi-select where I should be able to come in and click on Seattle, click on Buffalo, and have them both selected. But unfortunately, it just doesn't work like that. It toggles from one to the other. Kind of a frustrating little user interface there. I wish it had a better way to do that. All right, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.